I'm not here to teach you how to use copy and paste. However, what I'm here for is to show you how to use Terminal the right way. I'm here to show you how to do this and show you how you can become a Terminal pro so that you can boast to your friends that you can navigate the matrix. Subscribe and let's dive in. Today, you will master Terminal. Before we do that, let me remind you about DevFactory. It is at redeveloper.com/mentoring. If you want to meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call, you have a Swift UI question, or you want to learn how to build out iOS apps, go ahead and check out. It's at redeveloper.com/mentoring, a one-on-one Zoom call with me. Now, where is Terminal? Well, you can just hit Command Shift and just go and search for Terminal. There we go. If you just searched for Terminal right over there, you will see it's kind of this icon right over here. I have already opened it up, and it's right over here, really, really big. And the first tip that I would like to give you is to know where you are at currently in Terminal. So that is our PWD. So we are on the users/redeveloper. That is tip number one, PWD. Now, next up, we want to know what other files or folders are in that folder basically where we are at, and that is LS. So we want to list that out. As you can see, we are in application, documents, library, music, and so forth. I also open up Finder right over here. So as you can see, yes, that is my root folder right over here. So let's just go into the documents folder, because now you see that we have our documents, and that is CD. So change directory, CD, and doc. And I just start typing doc and hit tab, you will see that it's auto-completing. Now, as you can see, we also have documents and downloads. So if I hit the tab with the DO, it will not auto-complete. It will give us the two options that we have for the auto-complete. So I would just go with C and another tab and then hit return. And now, as you can see, we are inside our documents folder. Let's call LS here so we can see that we are actually right inside our documents folder. And as you can see in the Finder, in the GUI, we also see the same structure. Really nice. Now, how can we go back from a folder? Well, it couldn't be easier. We just go CD and two dots. And let's just list out again. We are out of there. But what if I want to switch between those two previous movements? I just go with the CD and a minus. There we go. Now we are inside the documents, and it's already printing this out that we are going into the documents. Let's just do the CD minus again. And here's another cool trick. If you just hit the arrow keys, in our case up, and we just go through all of the previous history of our commands, if you just go one up, you will select CD minus, and then you are going to go back to the root. I'm just going to go CD minus again, because I want to now create a new file. And that is with the help of touch. We just go touch and add the file name and extension. I'm going to go with test_file.txt. And there we go. We have created it. But how do we know we actually created it? Well, let's just go back into Finder. And as you can see, here is our text file. And it's empty currently. So let's just open it. So what we would just do is just go test and tab. There are many, so let's just go test_file and then tab file dot txt and then open. Oh, we're just going to go open, and yeah, there we go. We have our open. So I have done a little bit of experiments right over here, and there's quite a lot going on. So how do we clear this? Well, we just use clear. And there we go. Everything has been cleared. Now, what has actually happened is just going to move everything down, well, actually up, till this point. Now, if you want to remove everything, you just go with Command K. And this time around, we cannot scroll to the top. Now, next up is the open. So let's CD into our documents. maybe, so documents, and then open old, because I do know that there is actually a folder called old. And there we go, we have that. Okay, now it's time to open up a file, the test file that we have just created, and that is nano. And let's just go test underscore hit tab for auto completion, and this will open up nano. Now we can just add in here some hello there, and also we can read the file, go to the previous page, all of these. And this upward caret is actually the control on your keyboard. Now what I want to do is save, and that is write out. So just go control O. Okay, hit return right over there. As you can see, wrote one line, and then I want to exit, and that is control X. Now, if we take a look at that file under the Finder, you will see now that it has hello. How awesome is that? You can edit your text files inside Terminal. Now, the next one is removing files, and that is RM. And again, I'm going to use test underscore tab for auto completion, hit return there, and the file has been removed. Now pay attention here, because it's not going to move it into trash, it will permanently delete it. So make sure that you are removing only those files that you no longer will miss. Okay, next up on the list is making a new directory. So that is mkdir, and let's just call this test underscore there, hit return. Let's just take a look at it. Here we have our new directory created. Now, what if we want to create a file inside a directory? But we could just go cd into our test underscore directory and then create our file with touch. But I'm going to do this, I'm going to go back, and I'm going to do this from the documents folder actually. And there are two ways of, well actually, let's just do this with only terminal. So I would just go touch and then test underscore hit tab. So you know, that's our directory. And then just type out test file dot txt. And there we go, we should see this. So let's cd into our test underscore directory, and then list out all of our files. As you can see, it's the test file right over there, and we can also double check right over here in Finder to make sure that everything works as expected. So that is how you can touch a new file inside a nested directory. Okay, also we can just list out the whole directory. So let's just go back. So cd two dots, we are in the documents, so we just go ls and then test underscore directory, and it will give us a list of all the components of that directory. Okay, finally, let's get rid of that directory, and we want to actually get rid of all the files inside the directory, so that would be recursive. We are going to use rm minus r, that is for recursive, and then test underscore n directory, and that will remove that. And as you can see, no traces left of our test directory. Okay, so that is all about navigation, creation, deletion inside terminal. Now here come the last three code snippets, like a command snippets that I highly recommend. The first one is creating a zip file. So let's create a new file again. So touch test underscore file dot txt. Okay, and let's list out our files. Okay, there we go, we have our test file right over here. Now we want to zip this. So what we need to do is zip minus e, and then the new file name. So that would be maybe the same like test underscore file dot zip. And then the file path. So the file path, the easiest way of doing this, and this is again a new trick that you can learn right over here, is just drag and drop it into your terminal. So that is actually our file path. And then what we want to do is, oh, I just gone forward. Okay, so what we want to do is hit return again. enter a password because we entered encrypted, so minus E is encrypted, now you know. And then we just add in here 123 and hit return, verify password 123, hit return. Okay, so now let's just go ahead and open up that zip file. Here is our zip file, open it up. Let's see, users, developer, documents, and there we go. We want to see that, and there we go. So what if I want to capture this window? So screen capturing in macOS is with Shift Command 4, and then you have this nice cursor right over here, but you also, if you hit space, it will turn into this camera, so you can select the window that you want to screen capture of. So if we hit there, you will see that, I will just open this up, we see this screen capture. Let me just resize this really nice, but it has this shadow that's overlay, like after, before, well, actually after our window that we have captured, we have this really nice shadow, which we actually don't want. So that is our next trick right over here. Let's just remove this, and I will copy this out. It's actually going to override defaults. So there we go. Now, if you do want to have a list of these commands, go ahead and check out the link in the description where you can find the resources for all my tutorials, and just search for this video and you will be able to download all of these commands. So it's this one. So now that we have added that, of course, we can also revert that. Go ahead and check out the list of the commands. Now let's take a look at Shift Command 4 and then hit space and take a new screenshot. So let me just move that right in. Now, as you can see, we don't have that actual shadow, and in many, many cases, this is much more nicer. And yeah, of course, you can revert it back if you want to. Now, the final trick that I want to show you is actually two commands. So let's take a look at our dock. And I have moved my dock to my trailing part right over here to the right. As you can see, if I just hover right over there with my mouse, it's taking a lot of time to activate and it's animating it. Now, if you are familiar with my setup, then you will know that this, if I just hover right over here, it just pops instantly. So let's do that. First of all, I want to set the delay to be zero. So it's this line of code. And then I want to remove the animation altogether. So next up is this line of code. And now, there we go. It just snaps. And I prefer this very, very much. Now, if you do like these lists of terminal commands, you will definitely want to know why you should avoid nesting if-else statements. Go ahead and check out the video right over here.